Da er det snart tid for kamp mot Manchester United igjen, og derfor har jeg tatt turen til Manchester enda en gang. Denne gangen er det ikke puben, men i studio til Full Time Devils, og jeg har med meg Jay Mottesad igjen for en litt deprimert Jay nå om dagen. Jay, you're not the happiest Mancunian nowadays, are you?
I didn't understand what you were saying there, but I could tell by your grin it wasn't great for Manchester United. No, I'm not. It's not a good time at the minute. It's been a bit up and down this season. Obviously, you know, we've had some good results against City, Spurs, even, pains me to say it, were the only club to take points off Liverpool in the league, so that wasn't a bad result at all. Leicester as well, we beat Chelsea a couple of times, but, you know, we failed to beat the likes of Bournemouth and Newcastle away and West Ham and Watford.
It's kind of similar to what Liverpool have been doing in previous seasons when United have been really good. Liverpool would often beat the teams, or get points at least from the teams above them on the table, so it's quite similar actually. What do you expect from the match on Sunday?
I think I said this to you last time, or if not the season before. If you offered me a 0-0, I'd snap your hand off right now. We have been better against the better teams, and I think the way we play does suit us when teams come at us, which is what I expect Liverpool to do at Anfield. They're going to come out all guns blazing, and when we've counter-attacked and we've had that sort of pressure, we have performed better. Arguably our best performance this season was at the Etihad. City went for us straight from the kickoff, and we were able to counter-attack and they didn't know what to do. My only worry is that with your attack, the likes of Firmino, Mane and Salah, we could struggle. And, you know, and if you are sort of all over us and we do concede, it could open the floodgates. So that's my main worry with that one. So you always have a little bit of hope, and the fact that we have turned up in big games, you know, I'm never going to write us off, because I know it's not technically a derby, but it's got that derby sort of feel to it. And United and Liverpool, for me, is the biggest game in the league, the biggest game of the season. So it's always got that derby feel to it. And there's always that element of, you don't know what's going to happen. I mean, when we were rampant, you mentioned it, we were winning titles. I remember Liverpool a few times, the Danny Murphy goals, you probably know about, where I think you won 1-0 three times on the trot. We were winning titles, but you kept beating us. So it can happen. But, I mean, you're on course to break all sorts of records this season. So it's going to be very difficult for Manchester United. I mean, it's so sad for me to say it, but I'll be honest with you. If we were to win this game, it'd mean so much, because it'd stop you having the undefeated season. It wouldn't stop you winning the title, because that's done. You're going to win the title. And obviously, it'd give us a massive boost. But I think it's going to be a very long afternoon. It's going to be very difficult, yeah. So
loads of people on social media keep throwing, like, hashtag tainted title around. Are you one of them, or do you think Liverpool deserve what they've achieved so far?
I think it's a bit of both. Obviously, you're the best team in the country. I'm genuinely worried, and I've said this loads of times, that you're going to do a lot. Mm-hmm. I'm worried that you'll win the Champions League again and you'll win the league. I don't want you to. I'd rather you didn't win anything. But I don't think it's a particularly great set of teams in Europe, and I think you are probably the standout team. Domestically, you've been rampant. Yes, I think VAR's helped you. I know everyone said, well, even VAR's, you know, it's fair for everyone. I don't think it has been. But regardless of VAR, you were going to win this title because you cut above everyone else. City haven't turned up this season. The one time we were asking them to do anything, they can't help us. So, yeah, thanks for that.
The one time we needed you to help us. Thanks for that.
Yes, all right, that's fair comment. Leicester City flat to deceive. I don't think anyone really thought Leicester City were going to be in a conversation. So there's a little bit of element of a title, but I think you can't really say Liverpool have only won the title because of VAR. If you won it by 1 point, and it was a VAR decision, yeah, fair enough. But the likelihood is you're going to win this title by about 17, 18 points. There's only one team that deserves to win the title this season, and it's sticking in my throat, but I'm going to say it's you lot.
Okay, so to wrap this up, predictions for Sunday?
Do you know what? I'm going to be crazily positive. I'm going to say we're going to defy the odds, end your unbeaten run, and get a 2-1 win. But that's my heart speaking, not my head, if I'm being honest. I don't think there's much chance of that, but I'll say anyway.